mean the growth. Okay, so that is akidah, right? And then, where is the sharia? Everything, right? Everything. We as Muslim have to believe in oneness of Allah, the creator of all things, right? And then, we are required by the sharia to live in harmony. And we respect to each other, right? Especially the younger one to respect the elderly, right? So this is all about Islam, okay? So don't look at this as a piece of apa? Poem ke apa kan? Tapi it is something that has message, okay? So let's just go and take a look at one example of the. Okay, for example this one. Tumbuh berpunca, right? So this is the source. Okay? Punca penuh rahsia, okay? And then sambung. Ha? Tumbuh tidak menunjuk
kawan.
Kawan. Okay. See? Dia tak menunjuk, ini piercing. Tak ada. Dia apa? Mesra, apa lembut, gentle growing kan? And then dia punya daun ni, okay? Dia punya daun tak ada bentuk tajam, tak ada. Semuanya dia ada lipatan. It is folded leaves. And look at this leaf. It is folded inside. It is folded inside. No leaf touch the edge with sharp edges. None, kan? Okay, so these are the disciplines or the characteristics that is maintained until today. Okay, and then the memanjat tidak
mau lawan.
Okay, no, there is no. They just growing with freely, you know, without in harmony, without causing some.
Enemy.
Tak ada memaut lah kan? Nampak tak dia tak memaut kan? Okay. And then, last one. Yeah, can you see that harmonious elements, all different elements are in harmonious relationship, right? Mm. Okay, so this is the philosophy, the concept that they use in the past and they continue using it until today. Because when we look at wood carving, the wood carving has two things. First is tangible. The tangible is the one that you can see. This is tangible, okay? You can see from your own eyes. But the other component is intangible. The intangible is the implicit meaning. The implicit meaning is this one. Ada tumbuh berpunca-punca rahsia. That is the tangible meaning. So to preserve wood carving heritage, to preserve both components. You cannot preserve the tangible component without preserving the intangible component. Because cultural heritage have two components, tangible and intangible. The other intangible, when you talk about wood carving, is the skill, the craftsmanship, okay? The skill of making the carving. So they have their own craftsmanship. Alright, so if you want to know the tacit knowledge about craftsmanship, you have to go and interview the wood carvers. Different wood carvers have different techniques and craftsmanship. Okay. And last, sorry because we have delay 1 hour. Actually, this slide is for 3 hours lectures. Okay. If you look at this one, furnishing fabric, block printed wool by William Morris in 1883. He already has the composition, right? Like tumbuh berpunca-punca penuh rahsia tu memang dah ada. This is English man, okay, a designer. He actually use nature for his patterns, okay. He use natural elements to create the pattern. He actually work on different materials. This one is on fabric. But if you look at the composition which was done in 1883, already have the concept. And it, I think it is possible that the British came to Tanah Melayu, right?
Mm-hmm.
In what year? 1905, right? So they brought along the works of art. Okay, if you look at this, okay, this is from Istana Jahar. Yeah? So this Istana Jahar was built in 18 something, but the design actually was not local 100%. They have been influenced by the English or British ideas, okay? And this one, fretworks. This is fretworks, okay? Fretworks is scroll works having perforations. It's not wood carving. Sometimes they use different media or material to form the fretworks. For example, metal-based work, okay? So, this is may not be 100% purely Malay. If you want to know the original or the purely designed by Malay, you have to look at the roof of the house that has long roof form. Seperti rumah tiang 12. Di Dr. Shirin sebab rumah tiang 12.
Yes.
Rumah Kutai. So these two houses actually very original. And the wood carvings actually very, very Malay wood carving. They don't have this kind of wood carving. Okay? This carving actually came in the early 20th century. Sama time dengan British punya era, kan? Colonialism. Bila tu? Awal 20th century, right? Okay, this is I think from my observation and my research stuff, okay? And the last, I want to show you this one. Okay, if you look at this one, you can see the tumbuh kemuncul, right? But this is from Bali with the... Apa ni? Ni nambang apa? Saya dah cakap hari tu. Barong kan? Ataupun dia punya dewa lah kan? Okay, but the growth start from this motif. So they believe in this kind of apa? Dewa, and they believe that the dewa dia punya Tuhan. So the growth they start from that dia punya source kan? They have the source, but the source is different. It's not Islamic lah. Okay, how about this one? This one, I found the carving from Palembang, Indonesia. And this panel belongs to Arab Muslim. Okay, and they use very simple carving, simple motif. But look at the design. It also has a source, Ibu or origin. And look at this one from Sri Lanka. This is from Sri Lanka. They also use floral design, growth. Okay, representing growth, but they put a pair of elephant because elephant for them is what? Okay, and this this one also from Bali. Okay, this one from Bali, but the central origin motif is depict a motif of a bird. Okay, this is a bird. And this one, if you see the bird, that represent what? Hinduism or Buddhism? Hinduism. Ni Bali. Bali Hinduism kan? Okay. The last here is from Istana Terengganu. It's from Terengganu. This is a palace from Terengganu. And the grove also depict a source, right? The source here is a secret source, actually. Okay. So can you see the universal pattern or universal depiction of motif with the growth concept? Okay, but the philosophy is definitely different. They don't have that kind of philosophy. That is why the woodcarvers come up with this philosophy or the concept, because it differentiates between carving from Bali or from Sri Lanka, from India, what's not. Okay, from Malay wood carving. Kalau tak ada konsep tu, sama je kan? Sama je. So the intangible meaning is very different here. It's very important here. Yes, for sure.